Hello, viewers. I'm SB, and welcome back to Rain World for what might be a particularly harrowing day. We're gonna see what it's like in here. Let's get our trusty silkworm and get self. Okay, good start. There we go. So, the way forward from here is at the top of this structure. But it can't be reached from in here, if I remember correctly. I think we have to go... Oh, get over here. There we go. We have to go through... Hold on. Where does this go again? My memory is a little foggy. Oh, hey, that's food. Put down one of these. Okay, it's not really what I meant to do, but fine. Feast! No. Trying to pick up the delicious honey. Okay, you're coming with me, kid. Oh wait, maybe it's right here. Maybe this is the place. Careful, watch your feet. I'm pretty sure this is the place. All right, rad. That's enough food to rest again. Should I find a place where I can do so? I do not like how aware of me all of the elements of the environment seem to be here, and I'm also having a weirdly hard time making it. Oh, all right, to there. Am I? No, I am not. Well, you got to be at the top of the meter to make it through this gate. Okay. Well, that's very interesting and scary. No, I didn't mean to do that. Oh my god. Swing. I was just hopping to go faster because, you know, I do that and I didn't realize, like... Well, that's good. That's what I needed, was to go down the life meter. Okay, this is going to be a tedious thing where I have to just run around eating food in this area. This is maybe, I think, one of the worst mechanics in the game. This, like, building up days of successful survival thing. So we know where there's a bunch of food. And the spawn of resources seems to be... Holy heck, never mind. The spawn of resources seems to be cyclical. So like, if we take these things, they'll be gone for like a couple of cycles and then they'll come back. So I guess we'll start with that and then we'll have to go outside to find food on the next cycle. I'm just gonna poke my head through here real quick. Okay, there's honey here too. That's helpful. So we can get enough to fill on just honey right here in the building. And then we can catch a rest. The getting eaten by a mass on the ceiling that doesn't have anywhere near enough space in it for your body to go into is kind of frustrating, but whatever. Okay, right back to it. And so, like, what is the gameplay value of the thing that's happening right now? In what way is this interesting? But this is definitely the right way. Ugh, I kind of hate this. Shoot, I didn't mean to do that. Oh, God. Okay, it's going the other way. That's fine. That's good enough. So yeah, we plug in here, we sleep, and then we go back and we scoop up the little bit of honey that's left and also that other fruit, that fruit that's up there, and then we go out and we find food, and every time we screw up, we are lengthening the process by one more find food cycle, but after a couple of cycles, the honey and stuff will just respawn, so I don't know how much challenge there is necessarily. It's just kind of a repetitive task where the difficulty mostly comes from the randomly spawning enemies. It's like sometimes there will be a big goo spider in the way of your food and sometimes there won't. Alright, let's see. Where is... Okay. Problem spider is not here right at this moment. Please do not do that. There we go. Okay. So... Darn it. There we go. It is remarkably easy to overshoot absolutely everything with the rivulet, because the rivulet is very fast and slippery. If we go this way, we can get a fruit, or maybe even more than a fruit. We'll see. We'll see if the spawns are any different. Really need to be exceedingly careful. Okay, just the one out of curiosity. Is there anything further? Oh no, it's just a rock. Okay, so let's go find some more food somewhere. We're going to have to go back outside for this, which is not ideal. And I don't know where the good spots are off the top of my head. So this might be, there might be some cycles here of us like sort of flailing around. Grab a spear, I guess. While we try to figure out where we might find a food. Hey, there's a food. This is enough to rest, right? It sure is. Alright, we should probably have a spear with us. It's just, you know. It's annoying to eat while having two hands full of things. Okay. So this will get us to 3. We have to make it to 5, though. I don't think we should expect to see any of the honey respawning just yet. Okay, and the spider is watching, waiting. Basically just being a huge pain in the ass. And headed downward, it looks like, maybe. So even once we're actually allowed to leave the corridor, it's still going to be kind of a pain. Once again, I'd feel 1,000% better about this if not for the hard screen barriers, which I think are maybe the only thing that are a challenge to the charge up gate system in terms of like baffling design decisions. Oh, please, please go up. No, this is not up. What are you doing? Oh, it can reach through the wall sometimes. That's pretty fun. Nope, just climb up. You want to climb up. You do not want to jam yourself through that. I don't think they can. But if he doesn't fuck off, we're gonna end up being in here during the rain, which I do not want to do. Okay, looked like that was... That'll do. Again, hard screen barriers. Absolutely killing me. Here we go. Okay, rest. So, up to 3 we go. We can poke our heads back out the way we came in. There definitely was some food along that run, right? I'm not sure where else we might find anything if we don't find stuff there, so that's a little nerve-wracking. Oh, Jesus! Okay. So, it was raining still. That's what the computer surface is like while it's raining. Because, you know, sometimes we get those days where we wake up before the rain has stopped. Looks like it's maybe okay to go now. Although, as soon as I say that... Luckily, whatever these poles are made out of, it seems to be non-conductive. I don't know where my spear went. Let's take a quick peek and see if any of the honey is back. We have a little spawn here. Every little bit matters. I think if we're inside the tunnel, we're cool. Just staying here, but it would be really cool if the rain would just stop completely. Alright, I'm gonna go and see about that fruit. And there are poles somewhat regularly along the way for us to stick to if we... Okay. No fruit respawn. There's nothing down below. This adds a sort of a crummy dimension to this whole process. I wish the goose spider wasn't immune to everything. It would be nice to see it, you know, just sort of like fall out the bottom of the computer because it can't hold on. Or come on. Okay, a little bit more respawn here. Let's see about the fruits down here. The fruits down here have not respawned. Get in the wall. There we go. Yeah, this really sucks having to constantly be ready to jump on a climbing pole or something. This doesn't look super friendly. Let's get a spear in the main hand just in case. Please, slugcat, get up on the thing. Okay, cool. More honey. They look so upsettingly graceful when they do that, like, dive. So this structure, or one of these structures, is what we saw. Oh, I'm already full. Oh, you know what? I'm just taking food back to the shelter with me then. That's not what I was trying to do. I was trying to do a wall jump. I'm gonna have to climb up through the pole here. Not this one, this one. There we go. It is very pretty here in a very sort of like unsettling, otherworldly way. I'm sure the honey will still be good after we've slept on top of it. Here's hoping that the goose spider in here is kind enough to allow quick passage. And so we have a spot we can go where there was still more food, I believe. Don't know where he is. Let's hope. Okay. Seems like it's above us, which is pretty good news. And then the thing is, once we get this right, once we get up to survival level 5, if we die on the way to the gate, then we just have to do it again in like a way that's not... There's nothing challenging about it. It's just kind of like this weird rote requirement. Just like prove that you know where the food is located in the area outside the gate. Okay, we're getting progress on some of those things. Chomp, chomp, chomp. One more successful rest. No, okay, actually, the floor is not, like, sizzling. I don't know why I go over to that one, because I know I'm going to need to get up on the middle one soon after. I feel really unsafe here. Like, to get out of the central shaft area as quickly as possible. One thing Rainworld is very good at doing is making you feel unsafe in places. And this thing where all of the walls electrify semi-randomly from our perspective, is definitely helping to make me feel unsafe. Chomp, 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 chomp. Get in, oh god. Okay, it kind of like, that was a pretty half-assed one. The funny thing is, in a lot of ways, this area is probably slightly safer than it used to be. Because it used to be, like, absolutely filled with lizards. And getting food could be really problematic sometimes. I want to go see if that fruit has respawned before we try to go rest. Because it would be cool to go in with full food. Cool. Now, unfortunately, that means probably none of the honey is going to be around on the next cycle. So it's going to be hard for us to go through the gate full of food. Let me see something real quick. Is there a fruit or something that we can take with us into? There is. Okay. Let's rest with a fruit in hand as well. Because I don't remember where the next shelter is after the gate, and obviously we do not want to have to respawn on this side. So there's glowing mushrooms in there for people who have not been watching for the whole series. They are edible. You can eat them, and consuming them, they're not food, but consuming them seems to make time slow down in a way that's very obviously like they have a psychedelic effect on the slugcat. I'm not actually sure if they're beneficial, like if it's just a time slow that equally affects everything, or if it's if other stuff slows down more than you do. But suspect is not the word I want. I could see how it might be useful. Boy, we sure are gaining progress on the monk and the saint very quickly. I'm not sure what they are for, but part of me almost wants to try to do another cycle or two here, just to see if we can put together another passage or two. Let's run over and see what the food situation is like. Oh, that's right. I go left because you can't just climb up the middle one because there's a big block in the way. That would explain it. It makes my behavior comprehensible. Do love a very energetic backflip. We already have one passage that I don't really know what to do with. And in any case, like, this can just be making sure we have food for resting after the making sure we have food for resting after the gate as soon as we find a place to do so. Here's hoping that spider doesn't notice us. Okay. Come on. Why am I not able to wall jump all of a sudden? There we go. That's a spear. I was gonna say we should probably be on the lookout for a weapon. Thank you for not trying to consume me. Okay. Let's get through that gate and get the hell out of here. And we shouldn't have to cross a place where we are in any danger from the goose spider that lives in here. I'm not gonna try to charge up the things. I'm just gonna move forward. Like I said, we already have one passage, and we don't know what we would do with it, so there's no sense in banking a bunch of a resource that I may not even use any of. Should I be carrying a unit of food instead of a spear? I don't know, maybe. Maybe that would be a better sort of long-term survival tool, or medium-term survival tool. There we go. It's remarkably difficult to get in here. Okay, now we're allowed through. Somehow the gate knows this. It knows this thing about us. I still have no idea, like, what diegetically that system could possibly represent. I mean, I guess it must be something about your physical biology if there are sensors that are able to read it and differentiate. Okay. Here we are in an area that is now just called the Rot. That's not the usual name for this place. So you may be noticing that there's some weirdness going on already. None of it is our concern. Right now, all that matters is sleeping on this side of the gate. Okay, now we don't have to worry about the counter. So I wonder how the rivulet's going to perform in this area. Also, I wonder how close we're going to end up to these two achievements. Oh wow, we were right on top of the monk. The monk was definitely only a cycle away from completion. Let's put the spear in the main hand so that we can throw it for momentum. And let's see. Okay. The gravity stuff is already occurring. So, wait, where can we, okay, I see, there's an opening at the top. Honestly, it looks like a lot of the central area here is those blue orbs that make up the rot stuff, the rot spiders, but they've died out, like depowered. Go down, swim downward, cat. There we go. That thing's food. The thing that just fell from the roof. Okay, those are here. I'm gonna throw my spear then. try to catch some of those. Oh, I don't want to drop my silkworm. Actually, maybe I do. Honestly, the silkworm is kind of a pain in the ass in a low gravity environment. Oh, I dropped it. Well, whether or not I wanted to drop it, it's gone now. And having consumed one of these things makes you naturally generate light, which is very rad. Where did the other one go? There it is. No. Oh, no. I was trying to climb down the rope there. No such luck. Okay. So yeah, this area is going to be a lot of that. Going to be a lot of desperate attempts to climb. I'm going to leave the silkworm behind on purpose, actually. Because I am remembering that in this area, the silkworm can be a real detriment. Because you can kick off of, you can kick off of surfaces during no gravity time to generate momentum in that way I just did. But if you're holding one of those worms, it doesn't always work. Why did I do that? Why would I? To be clear, I'm not, complaining about the controls there. That 100% is, I pressed the buttons to make that occur. But I just don't know why I would do that. Oh, man. Give me that. They're actually really hard to grab. Alright, cool. Having eaten one makes me feel a lot better. It is so nice to just generate your own light. So there's two more, and I would love to get them both, but I also certainly don't want to die for it. The rot spiders certainly have no interest in them. I wish that having eaten them would make the same true of me. So the only way to go is down? Okay. I was going to say, isn't that just going to take us into the room we were in a minute ago that we saw? But no, I forgot. We've transferred a whole screen over to the left at this point. Climb. Oh, God. Just go down. Jeez. It is really hard. Ooh. The cystic conduit. This is an interesting appearance of us. Huh. Oh, those are like steam. I was like, what in the hell is moving in the shadows? I guess let's see what's up. Because the place we're going is generally upward, right? Okay. We are now full. Full is good. I like full. How do I maneuver in here? We're running into the problem of it being very difficult to tell in the game what is foreground and what is background. Actually curious what's this way. This would be a cool time for the gravity to turn off. There we go. Ugh. Alright. So you can kind of kick yourself diagonally of a wall. Those are, there's a live tentacles, I think. Maybe I'm wrong. Oh, this is, yeah. Once again, the difficulty of telling whether things are foreground or background in this game is significant. All right. Let the gravity come back off. shit. Okay. Everything's fine. We were headed in the right direction, I think. Again, it's really hard to know our way around here, and I feel like this is totally different from any other path I've ever taken through this area, so it might be the case that we're not even going where I think we're going, but upward is generally good, I think. Alright, seems safe enough to go up here. So I'd really like to be over there. Where does this go? Oh, I know this room. This room looked different last time I was here. Okay, so that the top of this room is I'm pretty sure the right way. So we gotta kick out, when the gravity goes off, we gotta kick out, grab that, and then climb up to the point where we can, oh, this thing's gonna have some, you can tell, it has some effects on the local gravity, doesn't gravity so good? Alright. Soon as, it'd be so easy to die here. As soon as the gravity turns back off, kick. Just grab it. There we go. Pretty good. Pretty good. Yeah. Now, sadly, this is the correct direction, but we have a distance to go, and it's going to be very dangerous, and there's not probably going to be a lot of places to sleep. Oh, okay. Yeah, this hallway to the left? Don't like that. Shoot, no, I don't want to be here. I want to be attached to the... Yeah, there we go. No! Oh, come on! Oh, it hasn't actually eaten me. Well, that didn't help. I tried... Throwing the spear imparts some momentum to you, so sometimes you can use it to like wrench yourself free of the grasp of something that has you. Didn't work there, sadly. Well, that really sucks because we are like, there is so much travel between here and where we died. Let me explore a little bit, I guess. Let's go somewhere. No. And up from here is obviously a really bad idea, so I guess this is just, it really is just the one way. There's a couple of different ways to go the one way, but it is just one way. Okay. Yo, unfriendly tentacle. Fuck off. Damn it. Give me. Yeah, feast. Okay. So it'd be nice to get at least two more of these things. It would be really cool to leave this room with all of them. But they kind of just have to come to me. Ah, shoot. I did not want to let go of that. That was my anchor. I was just going to live there. Well, at this point, I think... Smart money's on grab a tentacle. Although, if I get to choose, probably it's this one, right? Holy hell. The verticality of this slug cat. Got him. Alright, it would be really cool if y'all would just come over here and say howdy. Come on, come on. Oh, it was close. I dropped my spear. Well, now the spear is in the goose biters. It was a good spear, and we will always cherish it. So when you're when you're affected by gravity, when you're on the ground or whatever, in order to drop a spear or drop an item you're holding, you have to press down and the grab key. But when the gravity is... It's sort of like you have to... you have to be pressing like the neutral direction. So when the gravity is off, or you have to be pressing the direction that matches gravity. When the gravity is off, it's really easy to just be trying to grab stuff and have the slug cat read that as release the object I'm holding. All right, this thing's not coming. Let's just head down. There are more. There will be more in the future. What if we went this way? I don't think this is going to be right, but I'm curious. What's over here? Yo, no, fuck this. Because relative to where we ended up... Oh, right. It doesn't save your memories between lives. It's actually really annoying. Okay. Well, I think we just want to go up. I'm pretty sure. That area, the area we got to was familiar to me. The perfect trap. Nothing could possibly get past our huge ass. Okay. The amount of like zero challenge gravity swimming we have to do here is kind of annoying. I really wish there was a save shortly before the part where it actually becomes difficult. I guess we could try this. We didn't try this, did we? I just went down into the side there. Let's see what's left. Maybe this is a more direct way to the place I want to be anyway. Except it looks kind of like a dead end. Oh, shoot. I've lost contact with the ground. Okay, you can like sort of flail your tail and get some degree of motion in the air, but it's not perfect, obviously. Okay, I was trying really hard to grab onto any of that. It does look like this is just a big dead end, doesn't it? Here we go. There we go. Is there a way out up top? No, it does seem like completely a dead end. That area would probably have been traversable at other times in the timeline. Okay. Go. Okay. Actually harrowing. More spears. More spears is more good. This is a scary place to be. I don't like it here. Oh. Sometimes they just don't grab stuff. If you're pressing a direction along the grabbable object, it's supposed to just grab. But sometimes the slug cat is like, no, you know what? I know better. I will not do the thing I am commanded. I will do a secret third thing. And see, now I'm worried every time we see one of those walls. I'm worried that we are going to get tentacle lashed. Okay, there we go. We've made it to here again. This is the place where it becomes like a little bit dangerous. Ooh, no, oh man. Come on. I'm trying to crawl down the vine. Ugh, the gravity took too long to come back on. If the gravity had snapped back on like even a quarter of a second sooner, I think we would have just fallen out. All right, we will try this one more time because this is a really tedious section, and if we don't get it here, I will do it off camera and bring y'all in at the end. But I really hate these bits where hate is strong. I do not hate, but I am very annoyed by, as a person producing video content, these bits where it is like, it's a whole bunch of stuff you can't possibly, like, it's a whole bunch of zero danger stuff for a while, and then there's a hard part after that, and you just have to go through the not exciting stuff over and over again every time you fail at the other thing. Okay, that's helpful. I'm gonna wait until the gravity comes back on. This room is so easy to traverse when the gravity is live. Well, probably not even, well, I was gonna say, probably not even bother eating any more of the phage things here, but if they're gonna fly directly into my hand, feels irresponsible not to eat. Almost. That's not quite right. There we go. Once again, I seem to have lost my spear, and I'm not sure where. That is potentially bad. We might need one. We certainly did. We certainly have, like, suddenly needed one a couple times in the past. Okay. Up. Grab this, kick up again. Can I make it? I cannot. I'm not going to try to grab onto the tentacle there. That seems like a recipe for disaster. We're just going to hang right here. Because this is pretty easy to do. I went, like, way sideways for some reason. Oh, cool. There's this tiny little bit of garbage on the wall. Yep, all right. Tiny, just like, just so if you don't do things exactly perfect, you can get grabbed and have to start the cycle over. Okay, like I said, I'm just going to do this off camera, and when you come back next time, we will be at the end of the boring rot traversal section after all of the boring not rot traversal sections and ready to actually move forward with the damn game. And we'll see you then.